Now that you've learned about the process of xenotransplantation during part one of this video series on the first pig-to-human heart transplant, we are going to dive into more detail on the actual surgical procedure and the implications it has for the medical world in this video, understanding the first pig-to-human transplant beyond the headlines. Imagine a world where once severe, life-threatening conditions could be diminished, replaced by survivable conditions that do not limit the lives of ill individuals. Through the power of transplantations, this vision could become a reality. Discuss in part one, risks such as rejection and the resulting infections can restrict the feasibility of transplants in the medical world. However, the major factor contributing to limited organ transplants is a lack of organ availability. Lack of human donors stems from reluctance by donors or their families, along with the difficulty of obtaining viable organs from deceased patients. This has led to an average waiting time of 3 to 5 years for organ transplants. And unfortunately, it's estimated that 22 people a day will die waiting for organ donors. These alarming statistics drove Dr. Griffith and Dr. Mohiden, along with their team at the University of Maryland, to attempt the first pig-to-human heart transplant. But how exactly were they able to pull off this revolutionary surgery? Griffith and Mohiden, along with their colleagues, found the best strategy to minimize the risk of rejection during the pig-to-human heart transplant was to genetically modify the pig heart to be as closely replicated to the human heart as possible. And this was achieved through modifying the pig's DNA. DNA is known as the blueprint of life, as it provides cells with the information needed to function and display traits that make each individual unique. Genes are the various sections of DNA that control different functions and characteristics of human cells. Everything from eye color to heart function is influenced by the genes we possess. Although each individual's DNA is unique, there are significant similarities in genes for those part of the same species. Therefore, in order to close the gap between the differences between a pig and a human heart, Griffith and Mohiden found that altering the DNA of the pig heart to eliminate genes distinct for pigs and include human genes related to heart function would reduce the chance of rejection. And they were able to do this using a gene editing technology called CRISPR-Cas9. CRISPR-Cas9 allows us to make cuts in the human DNA at sites that contain genes that we want to eliminate. So the human body has natural cellular repair mechanisms to respond to any damage in the DNA. So when the cell senses that these cuts have been made in the DNA, it uses this repair mechanism to correct it. Normally, the cell will simply repair the DNA by adding back the genes that have been removed. However, in CRISPR-Cas9, scientists will actually add templates for new genes. So the cell will instead repair the DNA by incorporating these new desired genes in it. And now we have altered the human DNA. More details on this biotechnology will be provided in part 3 of this video series. Griffith and Mohiden used the CRISPR-9 technology to remove 3 genes responsible for creating sugars found in pigs, but not humans, as the production of these sugars in the human body would likely trigger an immune response since they are foreign to the human recipient. A growth hormone gene was also knocked out from the pig heart to ensure the heart maintained a normal human size. And lastly, 6 genes involved in controlling inflammation in humans was added to the pig heart to allow it to mimic the human immune response. Now that we understand how researchers were able to construct a pig heart into a suitable donor for a human, let's examine the recipient in this procedure. David Bennett, a 57-year-old man, suffered from severe irregular heartbeats, and his condition was critical as he relied on a heart-lung machine for months now to have normal heart function. Due to a history of not complying to doctor's instructions, Bennett was ineligible to receive a human heart donor transplant, and the nature of his irregular heartbeats made an artificial heart pump out of the question for him, which led to his decision to give consent to be the human recipient for the first pig-to-human heart transplant. On January 7, 2022, Dr. Griffith and Dr. Mohiden removed the pig heart from the adult donor pig after altering its genes during its embryonic growth. The heart was stored in a box engineered to keep it vital until it was transplanted into Bennett's body that same day. It's now been over 2 months since the surgery, and Bennett is still in the recovery stage at the University of Maryland's hospital. Early on in his recovery, he did experience an abdominal infection due to the use of strong immunosuppressants to limit an immune attack on the new heart. However, he later recovered from this infection. Also during his recovery, it was found that Bennett's new heart was beating with excessive force and speed, which led to a prescription of medication to help relax its activity. As of now, this pig-to-human transplant is viewed as a success. However, the full extent of its results will not be fully understood until we learn more about Bennett's condition in the future. So what does this surgical discovery mean for the medical world? The pending success of Bennett's procedure opens the door to the possibility of using xenotransplantations as a medical treatment for a whole range of diseases. Researchers have already discussed the possibility of genetically modifying animal organs specific for the genes of each human recipient to minimize the chance of rejection. Therefore, each human recipient would receive organs genetically modified to best specifically fit their unique genes. However, at this time, xenotransplantation is still an experimental procedure, and only with time and future research can we fully uncover the possible harms associated with these types of procedures and the lasting impacts they could have on our society. Thank you. To learn more about the biotechnology behind this procedure, please proceed to part 3 of this video series.